boy, today JB gonna do some hopping, John. I was at the store when I picked up the black eyed peas. These are dried, a Camellia brand naturally, because this is a Louisiana product. And we're gonna make them with tasso and serve that over rice with the delicious tasso gravy that it's gonna make. I was wondering what to cook with this. I was thinking breaded pork chops, kind of bland. I mean, yeah, you tighten them up with slap your mama and other things, but you want to do something different. I'm tired of just regular stuff. So I found this, it's a new product. Look, it says new right there. And it's Richard's. Richard's brand, Cajun Country seasoned pork roast, boneless, and it said great on the grill. Sounds good to me. And look at all the stuff they got it marinating in. Man. Boy, that's going to be a slap JB good. So, this thing been marinating. And it tells you how to cook it to a, you know, internal temperature, which we're going to do on the grill. And just go from there, boy. Now, the first thing you do when you're making Hoppin' John is pay attention. You open the bag of beans. These are dried beans. And they were mechanically shelled, it says. So there could be rocks and debris and other stuff in them. Sand, who knows what all. Pieces of the machine that done it. So, after we rinse them and sort them, if we find any bad ones in there that are brown looking, which I don't see any, we'll throw them away. The brown ones I'm talking about. And we're going to get these to cooking. Okie dokie. So the first thing you do is put them in the colander, like I previously said, and bring them over to your zinc and rinse them. Look, over here. Rinse them. Rinse them really good. You can soak them for a little bit if you need to. Oh, look, here's a brown one. How about that? See that? A bad boy. Throw him away. You see any more like that in there? Throw them away. All right. For those of you who might not know, JB got all kind of utensils to cook with, knives, cutting boards, I got the plastic ones, I got wooden ones, I got the Wusthof Dreizack knives, a bunch of these little flimsy cutting boards. The knife of choice that I like to use is these Rodders. It's a carbon steel knife, and it comes with a little sharpener. And I got a fancy Chef Choice three-way sharpener, but I like this, because look, it's sharp right now, it'll shave, just with that quick wop, wop, wop. No offense to the Italians, they might be looking, but if Polacks is looking, offense to you. But, if I use these cutting boards, I gotta clean them, so that's out of here. I prefer the paper plate. And you don't have to clean this. You cut on this and you chunk it in the trash. You're done with it. Alright. So I'm going to cut up. It calls for a large onion, but I got a bunch of green onions in there. So I'm going to use them. And my little crawfish going to hold my recipe for me. See, he's looking at you there. He's made out of a spark plug. He's looking at you. He's recipe holder. Pay attention there, boy. Don't crawl off. You're trying to get away. You see that? I don't know. I don't know if I went over this with y'all before, but I've got a bunch of cookbooks, and this one is Addie's cookbook. It's from the American Girls collection, and it's 1864. was the time period that they're talking about. Kitchens in the 1860s, Civil War times, stuff like that. They got a Hoppin' John recipe. And the recipes in this book are really for children to cook. And my daughter got this book when she was real young and cooked some dishes out of here. And on the Hoppin' John page, there's a little bit of history. Black-eyed pea was a light brown pea with a small black dot in it. These peas were brought to America from Africa in the 1600s when the slave trade began. And who was Hoppin' John? There's all kind of stories about who was Hoppin' John. One story says that a man named John come a hopping whenever his wife cooked it. So the traditional method was done with bacon, which was a staple back then. They didn't do a lot of smoking at that period in time, although this can be made with smoked hocks, smoked pork tails, or pigtails, pig's feet, anything you want, really. But bacon was the original ingredient in Hoppin' John. Tasso is smoked, so I'm going to use tasso and bacon to keep it traditional and just kick it up a little bit. I got it, so I'm going to use it, in other words. So in keeping with history, JB going to use some John Morrell bacon. Says since 1827. I hope it ain't that old. Alright, so here's my bacon. I got on a bacon sheet. It's thick sliced. And I'm fitting to put it down here in the oven. Let it make a mess in there. Now we're going to go ahead and peel some garlic and onions. Loosen up that tripod. Pay attention. Oh, y'all want to have another earthquake? Oh, no. Look out, earthquake.